This video covers sections 107, 108, and 109 in Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course, and it covers the participles of the me verbs. You can find this in Hansen and Quinn on pages 395 to 397. We have been talking in the last few videos about me verbs, otherwise known as athematic verbs, which differ from our familiar thematic verbs represented by Luo, in that in some of their principal parts, specifically the first and the third, and for histemi also the fourth, they have special rules we have to learn about the kind of endings to add and which stems to put them on. So far, we've covered everything from the first principal part except for the participles, and that's what we'll do in this video. And from the third principal part, we've also covered all of the moods and voices except for the participle in the aorist, and now we will also do that for the aorist, and for histemi, we'll cover the perfect participle active. The participle active for athematic verbs for the present tense, of course, uses the first principal part plus the endings. Now, usually here is where I would talk to you about short stems or long stems, but it makes a little more sense simply to learn these as sort of vocabulary words, as you'll see. So, for didomi, we're going to learn the nominative for the masculine, the feminine, and the neuter singular, and the genitive singular for all three genders, because as you know, that's how you'll know how to decline it for the rest of the paradigm. So for didomi, we get deduce, deduca, didon. And then in the genitive, didontos, deduces, didontos. So it'll be that stem in the genitive that you will use to form all of the other cases and numbers and genders. So for didomi's active participles in the present tense, you will use didont, deduce, didont in the third declension, the first declension, and the third declension, as you have done with stems for the participle since you learned the participle. For tithemi, we're going to get tithes, tithesa, tithen, tithentos, tithesis, tithentos, which means that our stems are tithent, tithes, tithent. Again, as you have learned with active participles from the beginning, it's third declension for the masculine, first declension for the feminine, and third declension for the neuter. For histemi, for the present active participle, you need to learn these nominatives. Histas, histasa, histan. And then for the genitive, histantos, histases, histantos, which makes the stems histant, histas, and histant to decline in the third, the first, and the third declension. If you look at the genitive, you will see the short stem that you've gotten used to from the present system of me verbs. But as you can see, if you look at the nominatives, it really just makes sense to memorize these. So for didomi, the present active participle is deduce, deduce, didon, didontos, deduces, didontos. For tithemi, it's tithes, tithesa, tithen, tithentos, tithesis, tithentos. And for histemi, it's histas, histasa, histan, histantos, histases, histantos. Now, it can be a help to remember how these decline if you look at some models that you already know. So for instance, for didomi, not in the nominative singular, but for all the other forms, the second aorist active participle of lepo, lipontos, etc., declines in exactly the same way. So you do already know how to do that. For tithemi, all the forms behave exactly like the perfect passive participle of the thematic verbs that you know. So here I've put luthes, and it would be luthes, luthesa, luthen, and the present active participle of tithemi declines in the same way. For histemi, you can use the aorist active participle of sigma alpha thematic verbs as your model, because apart from the accent, histas will decline the same way that lusas does. Lusas, lusasa, lusan. Now, if we move on to the aorist, we'll be doing the third principal part, and we get to do that magic thing where it's simply the same as the present active participle, but without the reduplicated beginning. So, dus, dusa, don, with the genitive dontos, duses, dontos. For tithemi, it's thes, thesa, then, and thentos, theses, thentos. And then for histemi, the present the aorist active participle is stas, stasa, stan, stantos, stase, stantos. Again, you go to the genitive to learn how to decline the participle in all of the cases and numbers. You use that stem from the genitive. And you can, if you look, still see the short stem in these participle forms. The examples I gave you from verbs you already know still work. The aorist active participle of didomi really still does decline, mostly like the aorist active participle of lepo. The aorist active participle of tithemi really does still decline, like the aorist passive participle of luo, and the aorist active participle of histemi still declines like the aorist active participles of the verbs that you've known before the me verbs. Let's move on then to the middle passive system and the present participles for athematic verbs, which will be the first principal part in the short grade plus the endings. So if we do that for didomi, we will get didominos, didomene, didominon. This time we don't need the genitive because middle passive participles decline the way kalos, kale, kalon does. That is to say, just like a two-ending first and second declension adjective. If we go on to tithemi, we will get tithemenos, tithemene, tithemenon. And then for histemi, we'll get histamenos, histamene, histamenon. You can see the short grade stems right there before the menos, mene, menon. And we can move on to the aorist participle middle for athematic verbs. And again, we'll do the short grade stem plus the ending. And what that means is we get to do the magic of just taking off that reduplicated beginning from the present system. So we get dominos, domene, dominon, themenos, themene, themenon. And of course, then with histemi, there is no special middle athematic form, because if you're going to do the middle from histemi, you're going to use the middle of estesa, the transitive version of the third principal part, and there are no middle forms for the root aorist that is the intransitive version. Before we move on to the different histemi forms in the perfect system, I do want to show you that you can right there see the short stems that you are used to from the aorist active system of the me verbs. Now we can go on to the perfect active athematic participles from histemi, which is going to mean principal part 4 plus the endings. And just as you did for the active participles for the present system and the aorist system for all three verbs, it's really best just to memorize these forms as if they're new vocabulary. So, hestos, hestosa, hestos, hestotos, hestoses, hestotos. And that shows you exactly how to decline for the rest of the cases, numbers, and genders using the hestot, hestos, hestote from the genitive singular to tell you your stem for all of the other cases, numbers, and genders. And that's it. That is the participle system for your new me verbs. And that is the end of your basic introduction to me verbs. We, of course, will meet other me verbs as we go along, some of which have such unusual paradigms that they will get their own videos. But for right now, you know the basics.